So in this video, we're going to talk about decrease key operation and Fibonacci heaps. In the earlier heaps, when we wanted to do decrease key operations, what we did is that we just decrease the key and then call the bottom of PFI. And since the height of both the binary heap as well as the binomial heap was order log n, we concluded that the decrease key can be done in order log n. So we are planning to do the decrease key operation in order 1 in the case of Fibonacci heaps. So calling the bottom of EFFI is not an option. And the other major problem is that the height of a tree can be linear in terms of the number of nodes in a Fibonacci heap, right? That was not the case in the case of binary heap and a binomial heap, but in the case of Fibonacci heap, the height can be as bad as linear. So calling either the top down EFFI or a bottom up EFFI is not an option in the case of Fibonacci heap. So we'll do something else so that the amortized cost of the decrease key operation in a Fibonacci heap will be a constant. Suppose if I had to change this 32 to 26, suppose I'm given the pointer to this 32 and I had to change the value of this 32 to 26, I go and change the value to 26. After I did the decrease key, so what we generally do in any heap is bottom of EFFI, but we cannot afford to do bottom of EFFI in the Fibonacci heap because the height of the tree can be as bad as order n. So I go to the parent and check whether the parent still has a smaller value. So if the parent still has a smaller value, then we don't have to do anything. Our algorithm terminates. So that's precisely what happens in this case. If I had to change my 32 to 26, I just change my 26 to 32 to 26 and then stop. Okay, so because there's no violation of the heap property. Now let's say that I want to decrease my 26 to 18. So if I change my 26 to 18, there is a violation of the heap property because 24 is a parent which has a bigger value. So in that case, what we do is that this 18 will be cut and added to the root list. Right, so you have the pointer to the minimum. So just this is a circular list, you add it to the root list. And so if the parent pointer, since there is a violation of the heap property, I am just cutting this and adding it to the root list so that there is no violation of the heap property. So after I cut this, I go and check the parent. If the parent node is not marked, I mark it, right? So in this case, the 24 is not marked, so I mark it and stop it, right? So 18 has been added to the root list and 24 has been marked. So the mark node actually indicates that one of the child of it has been cut at some point of time. Okay, so now the question is, what do I do if after I cut the child, when I go to the parent, if the node is already marked? So let's look at the case. So we have to look at the case. If the parent node is marked, then cut the node and add to the root list and unmark it. That's what is algorithm. And so if the parent node is marked, then what we do is that we cut the node, add it to the root list and unmark it. And this process continues till we reach a node which is unmarked. If you reach a node which is unmarked, then you mark it and your algorithm stops. Okay. Or so if it reaches a root list, then node in the root list, then your algorithm terminates. Let's look at this example. Let's say that I want to look at this 61, I want to change it to 1. So if I change 61 to 1, obviously there is going to be a violation of AVL property. So what I do is that I change your 61 to 1 and cut this, the entire subtree has to be cut and added to the root list. And after that, I come back to this node. This node is already marked, right? So what our algorithm says is that when 54 is already marked, you cut this and add it to the root list. When you add a node to the root list, just unmark it. Right, so the 54 is going to be added to the root list and unmarked it. So the parent of 54 is 23. I keep going to the parent. After I cut the node and add to the root list, I have to go to the parent. 23 is again unmarked, marked. So if it was unmarked, then I mark it and stop. Right, so since it's already marked, so what I'm going to do is that I'm going to cut the tree which is rooted here and add it to the root list and unmark 23. So when I do this, this is what I get. Right, so after that I go to 14, so which happened to be the root. So once I reach the root node, our algorithm stops. So since I decrease the value to something smaller than the minimum, so the minimum pointer changes to start pointing to 1. So this is what will be the pointer that we are going to keep track of, and the root list is the actual linked list which will keep track of the rows of the tree. So the, our algorithm is, see, as long as after I delete, let me repeat the algorithm now. So after I delete, if the parent, if there is no violation of heap property, then you don't do anything. But if there is a violation of the heap property, you cut the node and add it to the root list. And if the parent node is unmarked, you just mark it and stop. But if the parent node is marked, you cut that node and add it to the root list and unmark it. And keep doing this, go to the parent and repeat the same process. Your algorithm will terminate either when you reach the root list or you reach a node which is unmarked. If you reach a node which is unmarked, then you mark it and then stop. So now we have to look at, so in one case, so what may happen is that when I do the decrease key, I go to the node and change the value. After that, I may have to cut several mark nodes and add it to the root list. And so there may be k such operations. The k could be very bad as order n. So that's exactly the reason why we want to try to do an amortized analysis of it. Now let's look at the case when a parent node is marked and we cut the node and add it to the root list. What is the amortized cost of it, right? So when this happens, what is the change in potential? The change in potential is the number of trees will increase by 1, but the number of marked nodes will decrease by 1, right? So the change, the actual cost of the operation is adding and cutting and adding to the root list, that's order 1. The number of trees will increase by 1, but the number of marked nodes, the change in potential is defined as 2 into the number of marked nodes. The number of marked nodes will decrease by 1 because I will cut a node and add it to the root list only if it is marked, right? So when I add it to the root list, it's going to be unmarked, okay? Since I'm so because of this, so the change in potential is minus 1, which will cancel with the cost of cutting a mark node and adding it to the root list. So every time when you cut a mark node and add it to the root list, the amortized cost of that is 0. So it doesn't matter how many times you're going to cut the mark nodes and adding it to the root list. So in the delete minimum, if the cost, since the cost of cutting a mark node and adding it to the root list is 0. So the rest of the operation is only a constant, right? So you are decreasing the key and you may have to mark a node, right? So in the case of a number of marked nodes increases, the potential is slightly increased by 1, right? So in the second case, that is when you decrease the key, but there is a violation of the heap property and the parent of the node is unmarked. In that case, you just mark it and stop. So the number of trees will increase by 1 because you're cutting the node tree and adding into the root list, and the number of marked nodes also increased by 1. So change in potential is 3, actual cost of the operation is 1. So the cost, the amortized cost of such an operation is 4. But if you're doing multiple cuts of the type which are marked and adding into the root list, you are decreasing the potential by 1. So the entire Fibonacci heap delete mean decrease key is actually the amortized cost of this operation is order 1.